for the stress in the dog, so you can take away the stressors and start de-stressing the dog. Okay? It doesn't help to put on the bandages and thunder shirts and this and that. You have to take away the stressors. And if you don't find them, get help from somebody who can look for it and help you find them. Because it's there, believe me, it's there. Okay.
Is the first thing you have to do go to the vet to see if there is something?
Never see a vet.
But to know where he has pain or no, reason. No.
You know something? Most of the veterinarians I ever come across, I don't even know that dogs have muscles. They look for the skeleton and the joints and they manipulate and do this and do that. And they have no clue. So that's not the first I would go to. If it's necessary because of joint problems or skeleton problems, or you have to take an x-ray, or if something they need a shot for or medication, yes. But the vet is the last person I go to. To find out about the dog's tension in the muscles and muscle pain, you have to ask someone who has hands on the dogs and can feel the muscles. And that will be a physiotherapist or some people who work with that kind of thing, or a person who is good at doing massage, proper muscle massage. The one who is massaging my dog, because he needs it regularly because of his old injuries, she can feel very clearly when he's most relaxed and when he's tensing up a little bit somewhere, feels it very clearly. So that's what you should ask for, physiotherapist, massage person, or something like that.
Tellington touch?
No, it has nothing to do with it. Because Tellington touch and all these other, there are many different kinds of things. They call it massage, it's not. Because it only goes on the outer skin. Massage goes into the muscles. Teethers don't do that. It does something to, it can make a dog feel better in a way. So I have nothing against it actually. But for loosening up the muscles, you have to do something else. Totally different.
What about the